Hi everyone, myself Raghu from Tally Solutions. We welcome you to the webinar session on GCC VAT in Tally ERP in Release 6. For smoother business operations, it may require to use an accounting software that can handle the VAT structure so that your business is ready for VAT. Tally ERP in Release 6 is your perfect business management solution and VAT compliance software for businesses in Gulf. Tally ERP 9 offer comprehensive business functionalities such as accounting, finance, inventory, sales, purchase, point of sale, manufacturing, job costing and payroll along with compliance capabilities for VAT. We'll talk about brief update on GCC VAT. Gulf Cooperation Council has announced the introduction of VAT in few members of state of Arab region. VAT, which stands for value added tax. VAT is the tax levied at every level of value addition done to the product across the supply chain. It is levied at every point of sale from manufacturer till it is sold to an end consumer. VAT is an indirect tax and type of tax in which the incidence of tax and burden of tax is on the different person or business entity. It is typically levied on various economic activity like manufacturing, sales and services, etc. The next is input tax credit. In lieu of VAT, the tax burden is shifted to an end consumer, that is, the business entity is like an appointed agent of government who collect tax from the end consumer and deposit to the government account. This is achieved by allowing tax paid on purchase known as input tax credit or also known as input VAT to be adjusted with the VAT collected on sales known as output VAT. However, input tax credit, popularly known as ITC, it's a benefit under which the amount tax paid on the purchase is allowed to reduce from the output tax payable to department by taxable person or company. We'll understand this output tax, input tax with a small illustration. If you buy a goods worth 1000 dirham, paying tax 5%, and finally you will pay 1050. When you sold the same goods at 1500 and you will collect 5% of tax, finally you will collect 1575. Here, the tax part you collected is 75 and paid is 50. The difference between collected and paid is 25 dirham need to be paid to the department. As you know, from 1st Jan 2018, VAT is implemented in UAE and Saudi Arabia. Other states will implement at later date by mid of 2018 or beginning of 2019. Threshold for registration. For UAE and Saudi, if the previous turnover is 375,000 dirham or riyal, the mandatory for registration. However, there is a voluntary registration if the turnover is between 187,500 and 375,000. The businesses who are making only zero rated supplies are allowed to seek exemption from mandatory VAT registration. Registered dealer in UAE have to pay tax and file returns with FTA, which is Federal Tax Authority. Registered dealer in Saudi Arabia have to pay tax and file returns with General Authority for Zakat and Tax. A standard rate of 5% will levied on all supply of goods and services, and the time period for VAT return is either monthly or quarterly. TRN, tax registration number, will be issued to each person who is registered in UAE. Similarly, tax identification number will be issued to each person who is registered in Saudi Arabia. Now we'll go to product and we'll understand how you can implement VAT in Tally. Enabling and configuration of VAT. Here is Tally ERP release 6.3.1 or any latest release of Tally ERP. If you are an existing user of Tally, how you can implement VAT, we'll see. When you load first time this company in the latest release of 6.3, how to implement, we'll see. So here is the company ABC Electronics LLC. When you try to load this company first time, it says we need to convert your data to open it is in a version of Tally ERP. Automatically, Tally will backup. It will be backed up in the drive where Tally ERP 9 is installed. Currently, I have installed in Tally ERP 9 in D drive. So hence, an auto backup will be created in D drive. So once the backup is done, a next message will appear. VAT is now enabled for ABC Electronics company. So if you press enter, it will take you to the next screen where the company VAT details can be filled. Next, Emirates. You can select which Emirates the company is located. In this company, we'll select as Dubai. And here is the TRN number as specified, which is 15 digit. Registration date, 1st Jan 2018. periodicity. So based on your company VAT filing periodicity, you can select. In this company, we'll select it as a monthly, and set alter VAT details as VAT is already enabled. If you would like to see, just make this option yes. And here you can see the taxability is selected as taxable, and tax rate by default tally is prefixed as 5%. So, however, if you have few stocks which is exempted or zero rated, how to configure that we will see. Now, for all the stock items, the 5% is configured. So, once after VAT is enabled, you can go and check in inventory details, where you can see the 5% of tax is already enabled for all the stocks. So if you would like to view all the stocks from single screen, there is a report. Go to display, statutory report, VAT, tax rate setup. By default, tax rate setup will show in group wise. If you click on Alt F1, it shows group with the stocks. You can see for all the stocks, it is showing 5%. For any specific stock, if it is exempted, from here, press Control Enter and go to specific stock and select as exempt. Then it will ask the date. You can specify as 1st Jan and you can accept. So this is how you can configure tax for the company. Now, as we have enabled tax at company level, all the stocks is configured with 5%. Now, if you do few transactions, the VAT will be calculated. So before that, ensure that once you move to new financial year, you will change the period by pressing Alt F2, 1st Jan 2018 to 31st December 2018. The current date, I'll say 17th January 2018. After enabling VAT in the company, the next you need to configure tax registration number for Party Master. So go to Accounts Info, Ledger, Alter. You can select Party Ledger. Ensure that you have selected a country as well as Emirates. Here is the VAT registration detail. So you can select either register or unregister based on the party status. If the party is the VAT registered dealer, select regular. If not, you can select unregistered. In this scenario, we'll select as regular. Date applicable is same. You can specify the party TRN number. Next, go for a save. This is how you have to update party TRN number for each ledger. If you would like to do this from single screen, there is a report. Go to display, statutory report, VAT, update party TRN. So here, by clicking show all, it shows enabled and pending. As we have done for one, remaining also you can do it from same screen. So if not, if you would like to import TRN number from Excel to Tally, also we have made provision. From the same screen, click on export, ensure that you have selected Excel spreadsheet. This report will get exported to Tally folder. So in that Excel, there are a few fields which you need to fill. Post filling of those details, you can import back to Tally. So here is the Excel sheet which got saved in Tally ERP name installation folder. So now I'll specify few party detail. For demo purpose, I have specified two party detail. I'll go for a save. I'll close this Excel. From Tally ERP name folder, here is the updated Excel. Just keep a cursor on address path. This path you need to copy, Control C. Go to Tally. From the previous screen, import party TRN. From here, you can specify the path by pressing Control Alt V. You can paste the path, accept it. It says file imported successfully. You can go back to update party TRN and you can check the party TRN details are updated. This is how you can update party TRN details. After updating party TRN details, you need to create duty ledger. So how to create duty ledger? From Gateway of Tally, Accounts Info, Ledger, Create, VAT. Under duties and taxes, type of duty, select VAT, then no need to configure anything. Just go for save, Control A to save. So as we enabled tax rate at company level, even for sales and purchase ledgers also 5% of rate is configured. To check, go to sales account. This is the existing sales ledger. You can see here tax rate. So there is an option called nature of transaction. If you would like to create sales ledger with different nature of transaction, also you can create, else you can go with single ledger. So if you select not applicable here, during transaction you can select respective nature of transaction. So now similarly for purchase account also, rate of tax is configured. So this completes configuration of VAT in the company. Next, we'll do few transactions and we'll see how VAT will be calculated. First we'll go with local taxable purchase. We'll understand what is local taxable purchase. Local taxable purchase, for example, if goods are transiting within UAE or Saudi Arabia, so it's nothing but both buyer and seller are in same region. How VAT will be calculated, we'll see. So in this company, both buyer and seller are transiting within same region. So we'll go to accounting voucher, F9 for purchase. Advanced Technologies Electronics LLC. So to reconfirm, you can see here this party is also in Dubai and our company is also in Dubai. We are buying goods from Advanced Technologies. Tally derives saying that this is the domestic taxable purchase. This is deriving based on party location. As party also located in Dubai, in within UAE, then it says domestic taxable purchase. Select the different stock. Before selecting VAT ledger, if you click on tax analysis, Alt A, in a detail mode, tally shows what is the tax need to be calculated at the rate of 5%. So go back and select the VAT ledger and you can see the VAT is calculated. So this is how VAT is calculated if both buyer and seller is in same region. Next transaction we'll see, import with custom duty. So we'll understand what is import. If goods are imported from outside the UAE or Saudi, it could be non-VAT implemented GCC countries. For example, if you are buying goods from Oman or Bahrain or rest of the world, it could be India, UK, USA. In this scenario, receiver has to pay VAT on reverse charge basis. What is reverse charge? Reverse charge mechanism by which the buyer is obliged to pay tax on behalf of the supplier and is liable for all the obligations provided for the agreement and local law. Reverse charge mechanism is applicable only while importing goods or services from outside the Gulf and non-implemented countries of Gulf. So, as we said, VAT has to be calculated including custom duty. So how to do it in tally, we'll understand. The first scenario, so we'll create a new party, best zone is from Bahrain, which is non-VAT implemented countries of GCC. We'll go to purchase voucher, we'll buy from best zone, select the stock. The nature of transaction is import taxable and rate of tax is 5%. Here is the taxable value. So this taxable value need to be specified including custom duty. If duty is 5,000, so 23,300 is import value and 5,000 is custom duty. Total need to specify here on which VAT need to be calculated. Total it is 28,300. So when you click on tax analysis in detail mode, here you can see on 28,300, 5% VAT and 1,415 VAT need to be calculated. It's nothing but you need to raise the liability, later you can take a credit. So below you can see value overridden by the user as we have increased the taxable value and amount of tax subject to reverse charge. Even if you select VAT, VAT will not be calculated. As it is an import, you need to specify the import permit number and go for save. While saving, as you have done changes in as you have done modification in tax, it says either accept or override. So we'll say override. The next transaction is we'll do import from outside GCC country. We'll create a new ledger. Ganesh Traders, who is in India. So you are importing goods from India. Here also, you can increase the taxable amount considering custom duty. Total tax, if you would like to view, click on Alt A. Now you can see the total tax is 1850 and total assessable value is 37,000. Go for save by specifying import permit number. So after this, when you go to report, display, statutory report, VAT return, you can see here outside GCC purchase import taxable. It is showing total taxable value is 65,300. For this, the tax need to be calculated. Go back to VAT report, and here we are provided one more report called reverse charge report. Here the detail of reverse charge is shown with regard to imports. Below you can see summary of tax liability. The total taxable amount is 65,300 and total liability is 3,265 dirham. However, the balance liability. So as you have not booked the liability, it's still showing as balance liability. So now you need to pass a journal entry to raise liability, and also you can take input credit. How to do? From here, click on Alt J, nature of adjustment. You can select the second one, increase of tax liability and input tax credit due to imports. Now debit the VAT ledger, rate is 5%, taxable value is 65,300. It is consolidation of two transactions. The taxable amount is 3,265. Credit the VAT ledger and go for save. So once you're done with this, you can see here liability is booked. The same will be shifted to VAT return as well under reverse charge. The next transaction we'll do is purchase from unregistered dealer. It's nothing but you are buying goods from the dealer who is not under VAT. So as per earlier, if you buy goods from unregistered dealer, it was also under reverse charge. It's nothing but if you buy goods from unregistered dealer, you need to raise the liability and pay tax to the department. So as per latest update, all purchases from unregistered dealer is treated as exempt. So how it can be done in Tally, we'll demonstrate. We'll create a new party. Microzone. Who is in Dubai, but he is an unregistered dealer. We'll buy goods from unregistered dealer. Microzone LLC, purchase, select the stock, Tally derives that it's a domestic taxable purchase. So however, as I said, this, as per earlier understanding, this was treated as reverse charge. So in the latest update, this has to be treated as exempt purchase. Necessary changes will be done in product in the forthcoming release. So till that, user can override the transaction. So to get nature of transaction and tax detail, ensure that in F12, allow modification of tax details for VAT is enabled. If you enable this option, once after selecting the stock, you will get a nature. Here you can select domestic exempt purchases unregistered. Then when you click on tax analysis, there won't be any taxes. Even reverse charge also will not be applicable. Then you can go for save. So once you save this transaction, before that it asks, you have made some changes as you altered. Do you want to accept now and resolve the conflict later? So Earlier we selected as overhead. Now I'll select accept and we'll go to VAT report and we'll see display statutory report VAT return. So as we have purposefully accepted the transaction to clear that later, which will captured under incomplete mismatch or to be resolved. So press enter and it says nature of transaction, assessable value or rate of tax is a modified invoice. Press enter to continue. You can see here, as per the master, it is a domestic taxable purchase unregistered. However, user has changed during entry to domestic exempt purchase. You want to accept this? Select by pressing spacebar, click on resolve and just press enter, accept. This will disappear and it will capture here domestic exempt purchase, which will not show under reverse charge. The next transaction we'll do is sales, local taxable sales with discount and additional charges. Till now we have done purchase transaction, we'll do sales transaction now. We'll go to accounting voucher, F8 for sales, and we'll select the party. He's also in UAE, Emirates is Abu Dhabi, he got a registration number. We'll sell few goods. It is deriving domestic taxable supplies. So next, after selecting stocks, if you want to add few other charges, for example, transportation, then create a ledger from here by pressing Alt C. Expenses direct. You can select including assessable value calculation for VAT. This you need to select appropriate to either for goods or service or for both you can select. Then whatever amount you charge in the invoice, which will be considered to calculate VAT. So to check that, click on Alt A. And you can see the 1,000 rupees transportation is appropriate to all the stocks. The total is assessable value is 39,110, on which 5% tax is calculated. Next is discount. So if discount ledger is already available, you can select. If not, you can create by pressing Alt C. Discount also same, you can select assessable value calculation for VAT and you can specify the value in negative. When you click on Alt Analysis, even discount also will be appropriated. You can see this warning message. It says tax amount does not match. It's nothing but verify the VAT amount. So user has not selected the VAT ledger during sales entry. Then go back and select the VAT ledger and complete the transaction. 1,930.50 dirhams. If you go for a print of this invoice, shows like this. If you want to print single, either Arabic or English also, you can select. If you want to print bilingual, which Arabic and English both will be printed. The next transaction we'll do is supply to VAT implemented GCC country. Nothing but if you are selling goods to VAT implemented GCC country, we'll understand what is this. If goods are moving from either UAE to Saudi or Saudi to UAE, as you know, in GCC country, only Saudi and UAE have implemented the VAT. As goods are moving between Dubai to Riyadh or Abu Dhabi to Jeddah, anywhere from UAE to Saudi. So VAT implication for registered and unregistered dealer, how it happens, we'll see. I have a customer called BSZ International. Who is in Saudi, who is a registered dealer. His registration number is this. I'll make sales transaction. The goods are moving from Dubai to Saudi. You can see here, it's an intra GCC supply. So during intra GCC supply also, VAT will not be calculated. So if you are buying goods from VAT implemented country, for the receiver it's in reverse charge. So hence no need to calculate tax, just go for save. And another transaction, if you are selling to other GCC country where VAT is implemented to a unregistered dealer, so we'll create one more ledger. Is unregistered. It says domestic taxable supply. So it's considered as domestic taxable supply. Even though if you are selling to outside your region, then the VAT need to be collected. So VAT will be calculated only if you are selling to unregistered dealer in VAT implemented GCC country. So you can go for save. So post this, if you check VAT report, display statutory report, VAT report, which shows the detail. If you press Alt F1, which shows domestic taxable supply, Abu Dhabi, as well as Dubai and intra GCC supply. So this is the transaction which we have done now. So after intra GCC supply, we'll do few export transaction. Before that, we'll understand how export works in tally. So export is nothing but the goods are exporting from either UAE or Saudi to non-VAT implemented GCC countries, which is Oman or Bahrain, rest of the world. It could be any country. So in this scenario, no tax. So export is non-taxable. We'll see how it can be done in tally. There's a client called who is in Oman, and you go for an invoice based on the party location. You can see the tally derives saying that nature of transaction is export. So export, no tax. If you click on tax analysis also, the tax implication is not there. Just go for a save. Similarly, if you have a party in rest of the world, as we already created a ledger, Ganesh Traders, who is in India, you are selling goods to Ganesh Traders. This also treated as export. Both these transactions will get captured in the report. Display statutory report, VAT return, export. So after export transaction, cash tourist sales and inclusive of tax. There are three type of transaction we'll do. How to do cash sales? Go to sales invoice, select cash. Why cash sales is required? It is not required you to create ledger for each and every buyer, correct? For regular buyer, you can create a ledger. If one time buyer, you can pass transaction by selecting cash. So if buyer wants bill, you can print with their name, Mr. Imran, correct? You can select the Emirates, select as unregistered, and next you can select the product. This is domestic taxable purchase. Collect the tax. You can go for save. Second one is tourist sale. This is also similar to cash. You can select cash, Mr. Ganesh, either Abu Dhabi or Dubai. under tourist scheme. Under tourist scheme, so the buyer can get the refund of tax whatever they paid when they exit to their home country at the airport. So after selecting the product, select VAT ledger. Here provide details. If you enable this, it's asking is overseas tourist. If you make this option yes, then this information will get captured in the report, VAT report. You can see here Dubai the tourist scheme. The next transaction is with regard to inclusive of tax. So how to do inclusive of tax? Go for a sales invoice, select the party. In F12, we are given an option, allow entry of rate inclusive of tax for stock item. Make this option yes and select the stock. Specify rate inclusive of tax here, and tally will automatically calculate the assessable value for 10,000 considering 5% of rate. Select the VAT ledger, then this is the VAT. So if you click on Alt A, shows the taxable value as assessable value plus tax, and it will end up to 10,000. This is how you need to pass inclusive of tax entry in tally. The next transaction we'll do is sale with multi-currency. It's nothing but if you are selling goods to customer who is in a different country and you will do transaction in the different currency. So we'll add, ensure that you enabled multi-currency in F11 F1 under accounting feature. You enabled multi-currency. And then go to currencies and create Saudi Riyal. Decimal currency, it is specified. Now we'll go for an invoice. So you are selling to the customer who is in Saudi. So we'll create a new party. We'll select unregistered so the tax will be calculated. Adopter at 1000, then you say CR. In unit field, then you'll get a rate of exchange option. So here you need to specify one Saudi Riyal equals how many in dirhams. So this is 0.98. One real equals 0.98 dirhams. This has specified. Select VAT ledger. Then you can see 50 real is calculated. Now you can go for a print. When you print this invoice, it shows in both the currencies, real as well as in dirham. The right side is dirham and here is the riyal. Now we'll see how to do service invoice. So if you are organization into service industry, then how to do service transaction in tally. So go to sales or purchase invoice, just click on accounting invoice, Alt I, accounting invoice, select the party. Instead of stock item, you'll get a particulars. If it is an accounting invoice, then select the ledger. So what kind of service? Say installation, Alt C to create a ledger, create under sales account, and rate of tax is already defined, nature of transaction not required. If you want, you can select during transaction. If you'd like to select, select not applicable here and go for a save, whatever. If it is 10,000 dirham, then it says domestic taxable supplies. Select VAT ledger now. Then you can see 500, it is calculated. If you go for a print, this is how service invoice will be printed. So this is how you need to pass service invoice. Next is how to take input credit on business expenses. Businesses can claim input tax credit on all the purchases and services which are used or intend to be used the course of or furtherance of business. In simple words, if goods or services are used for the purpose of business, the tax paid on such inward supplies will be allowed as input tax credit. VAT paid on all other expenses can be claimed if meets the condition. Those conditions are used for taxable supplies. Tax invoice is available and consideration is paid within last 6 months. There are certain expenses for which a credit is blocked. For example, exempt supply. If you do exempt supply, you will not get input tax credit. Entertainment service provided to non-employees. Motor vehicle used for personal. Goods or services purchased for use of employees, etc. So for all these, ITC, input tax credit, will not be available. For which available? It could, if it is business travel, conveyance, advertisement, electricity, water, etc., you can claim input tax credit. So how to do it in tally? We'll see. Either you can do it through purchase invoice mode also, or directly from a payment voucher. First, go to accounts info, ledger, and create a ledger called travel expenses under indirect expenses, and nature of transaction you can select as domestic taxable purchase. Select as service and save the details. Now you can go for payment voucher. So if it is a cash purchase, if you have an invoice, taxable invoice, ensure that you have enabled two options. One is use reference number in payment, as well as again press F12 and allow modification of tax details to yes. Select the invoice detail, cash, travel expenses. So here you can see it is deriving as domestic taxable purchase. Specify the amount manually. VAT also need to be calculated manually and specify here. So total you have paid 10,500. Once you save this transaction, go back to the report and you can check. This will show under domestic taxable purchase. If you press enter, here is the one, travel expenses. So here you got credit as well. There is one more incomplete mismatch. If you press enter with regard to this payment, it says invalid TRN. Nothing but when you are buying, you haven't specified the provision of specifying TRN number in payment voucher is not yet given. So from here you can specify the TRN number and save it. This is how you're supposed to pause them. To avail input tax credit, you need to pause payment voucher through payment. So how to pause through purchase voucher? When you go to purchase voucher, ensure that it is in invoice mode. If it is in item invoice mode, click on accounting invoice mode and you can select as cash. Here, travel expenses 15,000. And you can specify VAT here. So VAT will be calculated automatically. So during purchase invoice, so if you select as registered here, regular, then you can specify the TRN number. This will get captured in the report. Now we'll do intra GCC subsequent transfer. Before that, we'll understand what is intra GCC subsequent transfer. Certain countries are not allowed goods to enter directly from other countries. In this case, other specific hubs like UAE imports the goods from other countries and subsequently export it to country where the goods are needed. For example, UAE company import goods from India and export it to Saudi. In this scenario, the importing country has to pay duty at the time of import, including custom. And if those goods are subsequently exported to GCC country, then a receiver country can claim the credit of the same. So if this is the scenario, if goods are getting imported from India to UAE and subsequently it is getting transferred to Saudi Arabia. So actually goods are not getting consumed in UAE, hence no VAT credit will be available for the trader. So during transfer to other GCC, it is exempt as UAE and Saudi Arabia are VAT implemented countries. So how this can be done in tally, we'll demonstrate. We'll buy goods from India now first. Considering custom duty, say 2 lakh. In this scenario, you need to select as import for subsequent GCC transfer. And when you click on Alt A, there won't be any VAT implication. So you can say override. And then when you are sending these goods to Saudi for a sales invoice. So Saudi customer here. Here, the nature of transaction you need to select is intra-GCC subsequent transfer. There won't be any VAT implication. So you are just transferring the goods. So this is how you supposed to complete the transaction. Select O to override as you have done modification during entry. If you go to report in a detailed mode, you can see here intra-GCC subsequent transfer, which captures here. Next is sale and purchase transaction in designated zone. So if you have a customer or supplier from whom you will buy goods, if the company is located in designated zone, or if you are doing transaction to a designated zone. Designated zones in United Arab Emirates are areas that have a special tax custom and import regime and are governed by their own framework of regulation. So hence, generally, supply of goods are exempted to these designated zones. However, if you buy from designated zone, it's like an import. So you need to pay tax on RCM and later you need to claim input tax. So few kinds of services provided to designated zones are taxable. So based on the transaction, you can do it in tally. So how to do it in tally? We'll go to purchase invoice. First, we'll buy goods from designated zone. Here is the party. Next, you're buying goods from designated zone. Here, it says domestic taxable purchase unregistered. So, however, you need to override by treating it as import taxable. Correct? It's similar to import. Then, when you click on Alt A, then it says amount is subject to reverse charge. Then if you select VAT also, VAT will not be calculated as we are treating it as a import. Override to yes. When you go to reverse charge report, those details are available here. You can see here, from here, you have to pass adjustment entry to raise liability and take the credit. So how to do? The assessable value is 19,880. And tax part is 994. So keep a cursor, click on Stat Adjustment, select Increase of Tax Liability and Input Tax Credit, select as Imports, and VAT is debit 5%, 19,880, it is 994, and VAT is again credit. So now it is liabilities booked. So what in case of sales? As we said already, the sales is exempted. Go to sales invoice. Same party we will sell, who is in a designated zone. Select the product. Here you can select as domestic exempt suppliers. Then there won't be any tax implication. Alright, yes. So this is how you need to pass transactions with regard to designated zone. Advance receipt. So what is advance receipt? Under VAT regime, when advance is received and same is remains unadjusted during the return period, and tax liability has to be generated and remitted to the department. So how to do it in tally? It's very simple. You are receiving advance from the party and you are not supplying goods in current taxable period. The goods will be supplied in next taxable period. So during this period, you need to raise the liability and pay tax to the department. So we'll create a party. ABC LLC is my customer, who is a regular dealer. I'm receiving advance from him through receipt. Before that, press Alt V to advance receipt. Either cash or bank, you can select. Here is the ABC LLC. It is asking what is the advance amount you are receiving. I'll say 10,000 dirham. You can see Tally will calculate reverse, and it says taxable amount is so and so and tax part is so and so. However, you are collecting 10,500. So for rounded value, we'll take it as 10,500. 10,000 is taxable and tax part is 500. Here you can select as method of adjustment to advance. Go for save. So during this period, if you are not making any sales transaction, if the sales transactions are happening in next month, then you need to raise the liability. How to do? Go to display, statutory report, VAT, and advance report. When you go here, it shows in detail. If you have received advance from more than one party also, complete information will be shown here. And it says here, tax liability to be booked is so-and-so, and liability booked is blank, however balance liability is so-and-so. Keep a cursor here and click on stat adjustment. Automatically it comes increase of tax liability on account of advance receipt, which Emirates, you can select the Emirates, and here you need to create one ledger called tax on advance. Under current asset, later you are going to lock off this, and you can specify the tax part here. Against batch, 10,000 is a taxable value. Now you can see liability is booked. So when you do sales transaction next month, later this journal has to be reversed. So now we have, if you go to VAT return, the advance details will shown under advance receipt. If you press enter, shows here. The same entry need to be reversed once after sales transaction is made in next month. The next we'll learn is sales profit margin. What is this scheme? The profit margin scheme allows that in some cases VAT is only charged on profit margin achieved on the supply of rather than full value. If goods are purchased from supplier who is not registered for VAT, or the goods were purchased from supplier who is a taxable person who accounted for tax on supply by reference to the profit margin. So there are a few type of goods on which you can pass this kind of transaction. One is second-hand goods are sold. So tangible movable asset that are suitable for further use or as it is or after repair. Antique piece which is more than 50 year old. Collector's items like stamps, coins and currencies, etc. How to do it in Tally, we'll see. So if you go to Tally, in a sales invoice, select the party and you can select the stock as well. Here you have an option, domestic supplies profit margin. If you select this, then in the next additional screen, it asks purchase from whom you purchase. I'll say XYZ supplier. Seller address, you can specify, invoice number, and the invoice date also you can specify. Purchase amount, what price you purchased, you can specify the same. I purchased at 12,000 dirham and I'm selling at 14,440. So other detail if you have, you can specify. So marginal value, you can say 2,440. So you can see here, as the rate of tax is 5%, Tally is reverse calculated and the consideration of taxable value is 2,323.81 dirham and the VAT liability is 160. Just accept this screen. Okay, so even if you select VAT also, VAT will not be calculated. Override. Then when you go to report, you can see here, VAT on marginal scheme it has come. If you press enter, then you need to raise the liability. Select this and click on stat adjustment. So nature of transaction adjustment is increase of tax liability. Additional detail is sale on profit margin. You can select Emirates as well. From here you need to debit a ledger called tax on profit margin. It's under current liability. So here the tax part, you need to specify 116.19, which is showing in previous screen, and you can predict the VAT ledger 5%. The taxable value is 2,323.18. So by this, tax liability is booked. You can see it is booked. This is how you need to pass sale on profit margin. Next, we'll demonstrate how to do sales and purchase return in tally. So for which you need to ensure that under accounting feature, record of debit and credit note is enabled. So we'll take example of any one invoice. Here is the APC distributor, invoice number 3, 17 Jan. So the product is a back iPad cover, 100 piece, $599. This is getting returned. Now we'll go for a transaction, accounting voucher, credit note, original invoice number, and the invoice date, party. This is the product returned, 100 quantity at $599 dirham. Next, it is asking original taxable amount. It is 59,900. And the tax amount is 2,995 dirham. We select VAT. This will be calculated. And provide VAT details. So reason of cancellation, goods sold, which is returned. Can mark off against the sale and complete the transaction. This is how similarly even you have to do it for a purchase return using a debit note. The last part is a VAT report. So after doing all these transactions, when you go to VAT return, you can see VAT payable is 2007 it is shown. Go for a stat payment for the period Jan. Either you can select cash or bank. And you can complete. So once you paid, it will come under VAT paid. So now how to file? Before that, you have to save this. You have saved this return. After saving, you can go for export. As you see, there is an audit file. This is the report. Based on the department request, you can generate and submit to the department. Click on audit, which shows complete information of sales, purchase, and a ledger which and all you have transacted. So this you can click on export, which will be generated in ASCII form in tally. This you can send it to the department. So next is e-returns. To file the return, click on e-return and fill the other details and go for export, which will get exported in Excel and it will be stored in Tally ERP9 folder. So this is the detail of transaction done in the month of Jan. So this has to be uploaded to the department portal. So hope the session is helpful. Any help is required with regard to implementation of VAT, we suggest you to visit our www.help.tallysolutions.com, or else from product itself you can click on help and it will take you to the page from where you can search for relevant articles. From the home page, here is the GCC VAT topics. From here, all the articles with regard to GCC VAT is created. Click on the article to know the details more. Thank you.